My name's Mike Bosey, mastering engineer out of Bernie Grumman Mastering. Thank you to the Mix with the Masters guys for asking me to do this. I look at this list of names over here and wonder why my name's on it. These guys are legends, the guys that shaped music for me as a fan. So to be included is humbling, so thank you again. I've been working in the mastering field for 26 years. I started when I was 22 at the bottom, kind of nighttime, part-time, and worked my way up to finally taking the room that my mentor, Brian Gardner, had ran for the prior 22 years, about 4 years ago. In that time, I've been lucky enough to work with Kendrick Lamar, SZA, Childish Gambino, a lot of hip-hop and R&B. That's my genre. Although I master everything, that's the one that everybody knows me for. So this past year, I've been lucky enough to get a couple Grammy nominations with a couple songs that we brought today. I want to play for you kind of a before and after. I'm not the most technical guy. I learned by doing. That's just my way of picking up information. So a lot of hands-on, a lot of trial and error, mostly error, before I got better at what I do. But just generally, and I'm sure most of these guys, even the legendary guys, would say there's no perfect mix, there's no perfect master. We're all just trying to get better every day. That's really it. How I master things might not be how you'd master something, or you'd master something we all hear differently. But I try and make a connection between what I'm hearing in a mix, what touches me emotionally. I'm part of a generation that grew up with hip-hop, where a lot of my mentors and other people in my studio didn't necessarily care or know what, you know, why do people like this? I love it. And there are touchstones from my past listening experiences that I draw on today. There's things in mixes that I want to see if I can accentuate without changing the mix too much to create a better connection between how you hear it, often, you know, what the mix was and how you hear it when you're listening on your radio. To me, that's why I love music. So I lucked out to be able to do this for a living. Hopefully you guys are interested in mastering. I'm not gonna do any stuff because I don't know what this thing does. I do and I don't, but anyway. So hopefully we can play some tracks a little before and after, and I can tell you maybe what I was doing, trying to get out of that track. And then any questions that you have along the way, if I can answer them, I'd be glad to answer them. Bernie did his little speech yesterday. He's way more technical, so if you were here for information on cutting vinyl and all that, that's when you should have been here. Anyway, really quickly, just what is mastering on a basic level? To me, it's two things. It's providing a proper master for delivery to DSPs or physical copies to labels, you know, the secretarial part of creating a master. That's what mastering engineers got their title. Like, we're not masters of sound. You literally transferred from tape to the master that everybody bought back in the day when it was just vinyl. So now it's gotten creative. It was creative before I came in. It's probably most creative now than it's been. But we're ultimately here to serve the song, serve the intention of what the music is. Hip hop specifically, a lot of people, you know, I'm not about purity, so I'm not gonna bullshit you and say I'm about the finest details. I work in hip hop and a lot of that is aggressive, in your face, intentionally clipping levels that are competitive to everybody else. I know that there's a push to, you know, the loudness wars are over. They're not in hip hop. If my track comes on and it's not as loud as that guy's track that came on before in your playlist or in the club, people don't, you know, they'll just say, oh, there's something wrong with that. It's not as loud. It might be beautiful. It might have more detail. It's just not at the same level. That equals bad. So I try and fight the good fight whenever I can, but at the end of the day, the client is right. So if you need your track to be hotter, I'm gonna make it hotter for you. Hopefully I can still retain some of that detail, definition, all of those things, add a little bit of my sugar to it, and everybody's happy. So, any questions on that before I have him play something? No, cool. One of the songs that's nominated for Record of the Year that I did this year is All the Stars from Kendrick Lamar and SZA off the Black Panther soundtrack. And I've been really lucky to work with them almost on their whole catalog since they became a label. And just to back it up a little bit, when I started in this business with Brian, was the beginning of the Dr. Dre era and West Coast rap era. So Dre's albums, Snoop's album, Tupac's albums, Eminem's albums, 50 Cent's albums, Bone Thugs and Harmony, Ice Cube, like all those West Coast rap albums came through the same console I'm mastering on today. So I'm just trying to carry on the legacy that was built before me, improve on it if I can, when I can. But again, that's just kind of my journey to where we are now. I think it would be cool if we played like half of a track with no mastering on it so you can hear it, and then I'll kind of tell you what my intentions were and then play the second half of the mastered track so you can just hear the difference, and maybe you hear things that I didn't hear or have questions about why I did what I did. So if you could play some of that, and we'll just give you a listen. The bottom ones are my bricks that aren't really bricks, but they're bricks. Alright, so when I get this mix, first and foremost, I listen to it kind of through the first time and see what the intention is, what the feeling is, what stands out to me to grab, to accentuate. This track, obviously, the bottom end is really big. The way that Ollie, I think Matt Schaefer actually might have mixed this one, he's got really wide imaging, and I want to preserve all that width because there's things moving around in that mix that if I am over compressing and boxing it in, we're going to lose that. It's going to feel like this two-dimensional track, which might be loud or bright or something, but you lose that feeling. So on this track specifically, I'm pushing a little bit of low end to round it out, soften it at points, but there's little detail. If you listen in headphones, and I know this isn't the perfect environment to listen in, you're hearing this kind of swirling constant throughout the track, and you're hearing movement back and forth. I love being able to put on headphones and reach into a mix, or feel like you can reach in and grab an element of a mix and isolate it, versus making the verse and the pre-chorus and the chorus all the same volume. There's no payoff emotionally to me in that. You're just level for the sake of level. And you're killing the dynamics. Like, to me, when you hit a chorus, regardless of what genre you work in, like, there should be a payoff where you're, you know, it lifts you up, it touches you. And to me, if I were to just brick this whole track out, I mean, there's a couple valleys in my mind up there. It doesn't have that beauty. So if we can play the mastered one, which will naturally be louder, obviously, but maybe you can hear a little bit more detail than the prior. Wherever you want to play. Ah.
expectations. I don't even want your congratulations. I recognize your false confidence and calculated promises all in your conversation. I hate people that feel entitled. Look at me crazy cause I didn't invite you. Oh, you a boy, you the moral to the story. You endorsing what the fuck, I don't even like you.
Sorry.
I'm about to pass out with a gift. That's how you find out who you're dealing with. These small percentage you won't build it with. I want the credit if I'm losing or I'm winning. On my mama, that's the realest shit.
Sorry, I should have brought a clean version. Anyway, so in that track, the driving force to that track to me is that kick drum. It's just punching, and that is the rhythmic thing that you're bobbing your head to.